This accordion is in the key of F or Fa, and I also have 34 buttons, which means I have these lower three red buttons. But if you happen to be using a 31 button accordion, you can also follow along because I'm gonna let you know which buttons to hit. If your accordion is in the key of G or the key of E, you can still continue to follow along because the accordion follows a pattern, so it doesn't matter which key your accordion is in. As long as you know the different patterns, you can learn the different keys as long as your accordion is in that key. I call them positions, so you have five different positions in the accordion, which it doesn't matter which, you know, the way you learn doesn't change. The only thing that changes is the accordion. So if you know position one, if you're using an EAD accordion, you know how to play in the key of E. If you're using an FBE accordion, you know how to play in the key of F. Obviously, the notes and things like that aren't going to, you know, you have to learn that as well. But the positions, at least, will be the same. I'm also going to be uploading all the different videos in your key. So I'm going to pitch things up or down on my TikTok and Instagram. I plan on making that a pretty good reference tool for everyone. So that way, if you forget a key, you forget a chord, you forget a note, you can just hop on my page and take a look at them. And if you can follow me, that would be great as well. It's gonna be botón.official. I'm on Instagram and on TikTok as well, so I plan on making that a pretty good reference tool. So for the first position, you're either gonna be in the key of F, G, or E. Those are the most common. If your accordion is in a different key, then the first letter of your accordion will signify what key the first position is in. To recap really quickly, the simple scale is 8 notes, 7 notes, and the 8th note is just the same as the first. It's just gonna be pitched up or down. You're gonna move in a downward pattern like this. And a quick tip on learning how to play a little bit more effectively and smoothly. Think of the scale as two different parts. You're going to have the first part when you're going downwards with the 1, 2, 3, 4. You're going to play that. Think of that in one part, 1, 2, 3, 4. You're also going to have 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can play 5, 6 and then 7, 8. Try to think of it like you're playing it in two different steps, so that way you can play it a little bit more effectively. So like I had mentioned, the accordion is a pattern. So you could see both arrows, they move downwards in the exact same way. So the only difference between the bottom arrow to the top arrow that you see there is that the bottom, you run out of buttons, so you won't have that last button to play pulling out there. So you're not gonna have it, but you see the pattern works exactly the same way because the notes and the buttons reset. So it's very, very similar. Now, the top of the accordion, you're going to notice those red buttons that I marked off. Those are there, as I always say, by the accordion gods. They don't follow a pattern at all. They're kind of just there to help us for specific scales and keys, which we'll get to. But they're kind of just there to help. So those aren't going to flow to a pattern. So you're going to notice that playing the scale towards the top is going to be almost possible because you can go basically from 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, but to play the last button, you will have to push in on the accordion, but it is possible. So for the 3rd note scale, that's gonna be when you play the first and the third button together. So you're going to play 2 buttons at the same time. Very common when you're playing, accordion music, Norteno music. So you're going to play 2 buttons at the same time. Now, when you're learning how to play these 3rd notes, it's very important that you use your whole hand. I understand sometimes it's a little bit, you get used to maybe just playing with the first 2 fingers that I have listed here with the 1 and the 2, but you definitely want to use your whole hand. That way you can get used to using your hand, and that way it just works a lot better, right? I'm going to list which fingers you should be using here, so make sure you pause and pay attention to that. Again, like I said, I'll put this on my Instagram so that way you guys can see. TikTok as well. So for the sixth note scale, it's going to be the same concept as the third note scale, but instead of playing the first and the third, you're going to play the first and the sixth note. So they're going to be a little bit more spaced out, a little bit more open sounding, sound. But the concept is the same. You're going to play two fingers at the same time, and it gives you like a richer sound. But the same thing applies. Make sure you look at how I'm playing them and which fingers I'm using, so that way you can also learn it that way. So now on to chords. So chords are when you play three buttons at the same time, three notes. If you don't know what a chord is, you're going to listen to it in a bit, but I'm sure everyone is familiar with them. You have happy chords, you have a little bit sad chords, and you have some that, you know, sound suspenseful, that kind of thing. And each major key, which the accordion is always pitched to a major, it's always referenced as a major, you know, key. They follow a pattern, so you're going to have three major chords and you're going to have three minor chords. So best way to describe it is, you know, major chords sound happy, minor chords sound a little bit sad, and you have a diminished chord, which is chord seven, which is I always call it like a suspenseful type of sound, maybe a little bit creepy, scary. It's usually meant to build up suspense before you can kind of resolve that suspense, right? So in Norteño, it's very common to use the phrases primera, segunda, and tercera, which, roughly translate to, you know, the first, second, and third. It's really helpful when you're talking in terms of like a song, but I wanted to help clear up that primera and, you know, segunda, tercera, it refers to chords 1, 5, and 4. So in other words, segunda doesn't mean the second chord, it actually means a 5 chord, and tercera means the 4 chord. And in Norteño, you usually play, you know, the 7th diminished chord before you move into the 4 chord. Some people call it preparación or, you know, something along those lines. But the 7th diminished chord can be considered, you know, the preparation before you go into the 4 chord, which, you know, applies to many different musics, but particularly in Norteño as well. Thank you. So it's important to remember that the seventh diminished chord of the first position, or in my case, F, is going to be used when you're trying to go to F. So in other words, if you're playing in the key of C or in the fourth position, if you're trying to go to the four chord smoothly, right, you're trying to switch up your song structure a little bit, you're going to want to use the seventh diminished chord of F because you're moving to F. In other words, you're going from C to F. If you want to move in through it with the seventh diminished chord, then you play the seventh diminished chord of F, which you can see here. If you're playing something like Norteno, once again, like I had mentioned, and you're in the key of F, you're going to be moving to the four chord. You got to ask yourself, well, what is the key, or what is the note of the four chord, right? In the example I give here, if you're in the key of F and you're trying to go to the four chord, which is B flat, you got to play B flat seventh diminished chord. So because you're trying to go to B flat, you go into B flat's seventh diminished chord, so it can help you move into B flat. As a reminder, if you can, please follow me on my TikTok and Instagram under boton.official. I'm going to upload all the videos and reference docs on there to make it a little bit easier. I wanted to make it like a one-stop page for you guys, so that way you guys could learn. I will have songs coming up soon, so that way we can practice. I also have the rest of the keys coming up very soon. I already have them. I'm just working on them right now. I wanted to get out the first position or fa out, but keep it tuned, and I will go ahead and release them pretty soon. I wanted to say thank you to everyone. I got a lot of views on my Mexican accordion video explained. I buckled up, and I'm gonna, you know, I wanted to make videos for everybody. Thank you guys so much. I wanted to fit in as much as I can, and you know, I wanted to just hammer out easy videos, but every time I start working on these videos, I'm like, you know what, I'm gonna add this, I'm gonna add that, I'm gonna do this, and then man, and I have a lot of stuff coming, have a lot of ideas, which I'm really happy about. So keep it tuned and subscribe if you can. Go ahead and follow me on my social media pages so you can stay intact. I'm also going to be preparing a button, not a button one, I'm sorry, I've got a piano accordion coming up soon, which I wanted to have so that way we can use it to play, you know, pretty much everything possible. So we have a lot of stuff coming, guys. Thank you for watching, and subscribe if you can.